at the 20-week ultrasound, they realized his heart was incredibly messed up. It was on the wrong side of his body. It was backwards. Things didn't match up.
Doctors encouraged Marcy Hobby to terminate the pregnancy. Instead, she and her husband Tom held on to the 10% chance that their baby would survive. Michael's heart rate was half of where it should be, and fluid was building up around his heart.
It was hard for me because as a radiologist, I see all these ultrasounds. You know, that happens in the textbooks. I see that occasionally at work, but it doesn't happen to me, and it doesn't happen to my friends.
I begged and begged all of our friends, family, to pray.
Everyone was surprised at how healthy Michael looked when he was born, even though he had a rare heart disease. Still, the doctors decided he was well enough to go home.
So we just chalked it up as, we're done. This is great. He's had the miracle that we prayed for, and we got on with our lives, and he was a beautiful, normal, healthy baby.
When he was 2 years old, Michael began to lose his color and his appetite. Tom and Marcy took him to a cardiology specialist in Omaha.
We really thought they were going to change his medicines. We'd take him to the zoo. He'd get to see all the little animals, and we'd bring him home.
But Michael wasn't going home. His heart was failing, and he had severe pulmonary hypertension. He desperately needed a heart and lung transplant and was airlifted to St. Louis Children's Hospital. Doctors didn't know whether Michael would survive the day, much less the potentially long wait for a suitable donor.
Over the course of the next few days, he had multiple cardiac arrests over and over and over again.
So now we're standing in the back watching our son being coded and trying with chest compressions, drugs, anything they can do to try and get his heart going again. And all we can do is pray.
When you're watching your son die and there's nothing you can do but pray, I mean, I watched Michael come in and out of life, wondering, is he going to pull through this one?
Close family and all of our friends, all the people at school, continually prayed for us all the time, prayed for Michael. When you're in that situation, you feel that. You feel the grace. You feel the lift of the work that they're doing.
Those prayers not only sustained the family, but something amazing happened.
I've never seen a kid who's arrested 8 times, and we were able to get them back every single time.
Michael was alive, but seriously ill. Dr. Gandy recommended using a Berlin heart. The treatment could buy Michael more time.
This is the blood pump of the Berlin heart. The blood exits through one tube, comes into the pump, and then goes into the patient through another tube. It was a bit risky at that point, because we hadn't done very many Berlin hearts, and we'd never done one in this sort of circumstance.
I think the chances of him living without this sort of therapy were zero.
After almost 8 hours in surgery, Dr. Gandy successfully attached the device to Michael's abnormal heart. Then 5 weeks later, Michael had another remarkable breakthrough. His lungs improved. He was totally healed of pulmonary hypertension. Now the Habbes family had one more major hurdle. They waited and prayed for a heart transplant.
One morning, and Dr. Gandy came in. I said, I think this pager's broken. And I started joking about it. And he goes, your pager's broken? I said, yeah, it won't go off. And he said, well, mine did. And I just looked at him and I started screaming. And I go, what? And I started screaming so loud. And all the nurses came running in.
A donor's heart was matched to Michael.
And we were so excited to think that he may live. If we can get this heart, he has a chance.
Michael's heart transplant was a success.
There was an electric buzz in the room, and everybody knew that this was something special.
What happened to Michael was nothing short of a miracle.
His brain works just fine, as well as the rest of his organs. He's one of the true success stories that I've dealt with.
In that time, God was asking us to just trust him. And we got to see that he's very trustworthy. He never left us high and dry.
God always was there. He was always pulling us through. And Michael's short little life, he's so extraordinary.
More than 3 years later, Michael is perfectly healthy and full of energy.
I'm glad to have a new heart. And Dr. Gandy helped me, and a lot of people prayed for me.
God has really shown me the preciousness of life through my children.
Life is a gift, And God gives us that gift, and it's something precious to take care of.